Customizing styles in the asset panel is a terrific way to optimize your workflow. Let's say I've built out many artboards with a good deal of content, and I decide, of course, at the end of the project that I want to change a color I've been using. Rather than change every instance of that color manually, I can change all instances of the color in bulk using the Assets panel. To do that, I'm going to come to the lower right-hand side of the interface. You'll notice there's two icons here. The bottom icon is the Layers panel. I'm going to select the icon above that for the Assets panel, and it opens up here towards the left. When you look at the Assets panel, you'll notice there are three sections. Colors, which we're going to cover. There's also character styles, and towards the bottom are symbols. I've not added any symbols up until this point in this project, so that's currently empty. If I scroll back up to the top, there are colors that have been added. The first thing I want to show you is how you can remove those colors, because I want to start from scratch. I'll come on in and click that top color. Then holding the Shift key, I'm going to click the bottommost color to select everything in that list. I'll then right-click and then click on Delete to remove it from the Assets panel. Doesn't take it out of my project, just out of the Assets panel. From here, I can add colors individually by clicking on a color. Let's say I want to come in and select this little color pod here. I'm selecting the stroke, the white background, and that color green, so that when I come to the Colors section and click on the plus sign, all three of those colors are brought over. Alternatively, if I wanted to bring over all of the colors, I could select everything on the canvas or just click a particular artboard. Let's say I want to bring in the colors that are included in this gear artboard. I'll click on the gear artboard name and then come back to the color section, click that plus sign, and it brings over all the colors in use there. If I want to change a color that's in use across my project, I can come over to that color swatch and right-click and in the menu select Edit. From there, I can pick a color that's being used somewhere in the design. So let's say using the eyedropper tool, come to this shade of green. Notice that not only did the swatch on the left change, but all instances of that blue color here towards the right have been updated with that shade of green that I've selected. I can also just come in and type in a hex value or pick a shade that I'd like to apply to the design. When I click off, the swatch has been updated on the left, and all of the occurrences on the design canvas have been updated as well. I can always apply a friendlier name to the color now that the hex value has changed, and I'll do that by double-clicking on the swatch here, and I'll give it a name. We'll just call it Primary Pink.